What's going on, guys? My name is Josh Sellage. I am the BJJ strength coach. Welcome to another AM Crew vlog. We're here at Super Training Gym to put in that work, dog. This is another bracket smasher training session. What you guys are gonna see in today's training session is we're actually gonna be doing some more max effort upper body work by working on our overhead press. We're gonna give you guys a few tips that you can start using in your next training session to really dial in your overhead pressing mechanics, making sure that your movement is looking good so you can lift more weights, build more muscle, get more jacked, so you can ultimately get stronger to win more matches and get injured less. So you're gonna be seeing a lot of dope stuff in today's training session. We have our max effort upper body work scheduled out for the day with the overhead press. Then we're gonna be doing some dynamic effort work with some speed box squats, as well as some various jumps and some other accessory work for our upper back. And then we're gonna finish with some deep, dark conditioning, which I think is gonna be pretty fun and pretty miserable all at the same time. So thank you guys so much for watching. We'll catch you guys after the workout. Hope you guys enjoy. Overhead pressing movements, you got to make sure you can pull your rib cage down. The reason being is because you don't want to overextend your lower back. If your ribs pop up, that means your lower back is extended. It's an extension, and it's not a very strong and stable position to press from, especially overhead. So that being said, you want to make sure that you're bracing hard, just like you would on a squat, just like you would on a deadlift. But if you can't get your arms over your head without overextending your lower back, that means you need to focus a lot more on your lat mobility. So opening up your lats, working on things like the foam roll lat smash, things like the lacrosse ball lat smash, even working through exercises like the dumbbell pullover to get a loaded stretch in that position will help a lot. And then the other thing that's gonna help with overhead pressing is really making sure your upper back is tight. The upper back is is one of arguably the most important part of lifting. It's bracing, second most important, I guess. It's bracing your trunk and protecting your spine is first important. Second most important would be tightening your upper back. You'll see, even you can see how when Kevin gets set on his set, as he's grabbing the bar, he's going to tighten up his shoulders and his upper back, and then he's going to get underneath into that strong front rack position. From there, you're able to press from a stable position, just like you would if you're going to bench press, tightening up your upper back. That way you can bench from a stable position. So tip number two would be tightening up the upper back. And then tip number three would be really driving your elbows underneath and slightly and forward of the bar. So if the bar is resting on my shoulders, or if it's in pins here, you really want to make sure that your elbows are getting in front. That's going to allow you to press directly overhead. If your elbows are back here, you're going to press out in front. And the farther out in front your arms are, the less amount of pressing strength you actually have, the harder it is to control the barbell, and the higher your risk of injury goes up. Tiny bunny hops. Itty bitty bunny hops. Yep. Yep. How do you feel, dog?
It killed me, bro. But it's good. It's gonna get stronger.
Yes, sir.
We're rolling.
And that's a wrap. Day two, week four of the Bracket Smasher training program is done. Whew. A couple differences you'll notice in this workout versus the last time we did this workout was we switched up some of the upper back accessories that we were doing. We made some small tweaks to our dynamic effort work. We mixed in some Bulgarian split squat jumps along with our lateral jumps. And our conditioning went really well last week, and this week it felt way worse. Like it just hurt so much more than last week. And I don't know if that's because we know what to expect, so we're anticipating the pain coming on. But all in all, it was a great training session. Kevin hit a big PR today. Zach hit a big PR today. I hit a PR also. It was a little ugly, so I'm not super stoked about that as far as form goes. But it did hit a 10-pound PR. Abdullah crushed it today too on his Z press work. I believe he hit a PRs also. Eric did an amazing job on his landmine Z press work. Did you hit a PR today?
Yeah, big time.
Awesome. Yes, sir. So everyone hit a PR today, which is awesome. So congrats to everyone in the AM crew for their PRs. You guys, the strength matrix is dropping January 2022. So if you're fascinated by what we do here in the AM crew and how we're able to train and how we're able to still lift heavy, how we're still able to pack on a bunch of muscle and improve our conditioning and maintain mobility, all while being competitive jiu-jitsu and wrestling athletes, you guys are definitely going to want to check the strength matrix out. It's going to be the ultimate resource for any grappling athlete that's looking to enhance their performance on the mat. Everything from strength training, conditioning, competition prep, mindset, tactics, and mental preparation to prepare to compete at the highest levels of competition. It's all going to be included in the strength matrix. So definitely be on the lookout for that because it drops January 2022. You guys can follow me on Instagram at Joshua Setledge and on TikTok at Joshua Setledge. And if you guys are interested in a free 4-week strength program, you can click the link below and download that bad boy. And I'll catch you guys later. Peace.